Well, ruling National Conference in Jammu and Kashmir is locked in a fierce political fight with main opposition, the PDP. And the biggest campaign issue of late has been PDP Chief Mehbooba Mufti's recent statement hinting that it has no problems with a Narendra Modi-led government at the centre. Roving editor Maruk Inayat sends us this special report from Jammu and Kashmir.
That is the nation I want to see. बजाय ये कि लोगों के पास जाके कैंपेन शुरू करें
और सुना ऐसे बने निर्णय लीजिए
वो ये शोर उठाते हैं कि फारूक अब्दुल्ला कहता हम सब सो रहे हैं.
While the number of MPs the valley sends to the Lok Sabha might not make any of the parties play kingmaker, the significance of who wins these seats cannot be undermined. PDP's Mehbooba Mufti is campaigning from South Kashmir's Anantnag constituency. For her, it's a tough fight against Omar Abdullah's National Conference, and she knows it. The PDP's hint at being okay with a Narendra Modi government at the centre seems to have boomeranged for her party. Mehbooba Mufti said alliance with Modi is an absolute no as she spoke to Maruk Inayat while campaigning in her constituency.
Mehbooba Mufti, there was an interesting comment made by Farooq Abdullah when he said that I want, if Rahul Gandhi forms the government, then Umar Abdullah will be given a berth. I see you campaigning for the Lok Sabha seat, whereas you are naming Mufti Muhammad Saeed, your father and the leader of the PDP, as being the one icon for the state assembly elections. Is it a question of the old guard coming back to the valley and the young guard perhaps moving to the centre?
Well, it's not like that. Basically, whenever we go to people, people, you know, appreciate those 3 years of my father's tenure when we were able to, you know, restore peace in the J&K state, give people a sense of security, have some kind of, you know, I think for the first time in the history of Jammu and Kashmir, agenda was being set by Kashmir in itself, by the ruling party that was headed by Mufti Saab, and both New Delhi as well as Islamabad were also towing that line. We were able to persuade the BJP government headed by Atal Bihari Vajpayee to take a pro-people stance vis-a-vis Kashmir and also adopt a reconciliatory process, you know, to, towards Pakistan, which gave very good results to us. So I feel that good work, the good governance, coupled with political process that was started by my father at that point of time with the help of both NDA and UPA, you know, it created a very good atmosphere in the state and people appreciate that.
Umar Abdullah in one of his speeches, campaign speeches, has said that you should never come back as a member of parliament, that you failed as one, and he's used a certain instance when there was a debate on the trust vote and said you had at that point said ab main kya kahun, and he's used that if you weren't able to speak for your people, then how can you really do any work as a member of parliament?
Well, basically, National Conference has nothing against PDP, you know. You have seen all these days, they have been campaigning and talking only one point, that PDP is going to align with BJP, PDP has, you know, this nexus with Hizbul Mujahideen, they have nexus with Jamaat Islami, they have nexus with Salahuddin. So had he something positive to tell about his...
Is there a nexus?
About his performance. I mean, you can't have nexus, you know, with both BJP as well as Hizbul Mujahideen at the same time. It sounds ridiculous, but since he has nothing to say as far as his own performance is concerned, so his focus is more on me or on PDP or on, you know, other issues, which shows how much frustrated National Conference is at this point of time.
No, but he says that you have sold your soul to the BJP and Narendra Modi.
Well, I think you recall it. It was Omar Abdullah with 2/3 majority here in J&K state and 4 member parliamentarians in his pocket that they kicked Saifuddin Soz for voting against BJP. Then Umar Saab joined the BJP ministry. He was there. He continued to be there even after the autonomy resolution was rejected. He continued to be there when, you know, this Gujarat incident happened. He did not resign at that point of time. In fact, Farooq Saab's party abstained from voting in support of the, you know, motion that was brought against the communal rights that took place in Gujarat.
But tell me something, are you ready to partner with Narendra Modi?
Not at all. You don't need to be. See, Dr. Kamal Mustafa said some time back that, you know, he will support Narendra Modi because his father, late Sheikh Saab, has told him that you have to align with anybody in Delhi. We don't need to share power with anybody in the Delhi, but whosoever comes to power in Delhi, they have to adopt a reconciliatory or positive policy towards Jammu and Kashmir. For that, you don't need to be an alliance partner. You don't need to have ministerial berths as was in case of Farooq Saab and even Umar Saab.
Will you work with the Narendra Modi government at the center, yes or no?
No, not at all. We are never going to join them. We are never going to be their alliance partners. I have been telling it again and again. But I don't know why this question is being asked again and again. We will never align with BJP. We will never be their partners at the
center. Why is it that in every campaign speech, you bring back the name of Atal Bihari Vajpayee? Many are seeing that because Atal Bihari Vajpayee will not boomerang with the people of the valley. That is why you're using his name and softening the blow. But ultimately, it means Narendra Modi because he's the BJP's prime ministerial candidate.
Again, it's a misconception. If you recall, when we had alliance with Congress, and Vajpayee ji visited Kashmir and he said that main insaniyat ke daire mein Kashmir ko hal karunga, Pakistan ke saath dosti karunga, and many other things, you know, very good things which had a very positive impact on our state. Since right from that day, we have been appreciating and applauding Vajpayee ji for his, you know, reconciliatory approach, for what all he did for the state of J&K, for his, you know, friendship towards Pakistan.
But tell me something. You said earlier in Jan this year that no chief minister has ever resigned over riots. But Narendra Modi should apologize for what happened in 2002. Very recently, Narendra Modi, earlier this week in fact, had an interview and he said, I don't have to apologize. As far as 2002 is concerned, will you not take up that issue? Is it not then fair for the opposition to say that you seem to have a secret alliance with the BJP?
Well, my point is very unfortunate that in our country so many riots have taken place. So many of them, you have lost count. And none of the parties, chief ministers, anybody has resigned till date. It was Shastri ji who resigned because, you know, the train met an accident. It was my father who was a minister in Congress government and Rajiv ji's government. When Meerut riots took place, he resigned. But my point is that Narendra Modi has to take responsibility for what happened in Gujarat, because as a chief minister, he is responsible for the life and security of his people. So if they died, it is on
what if he doesn't? Will you demand an apology?
See, we are not so powerful. It is for the people of the country, 540 seats. They have to take a decision. For us, you know, as a political party, if you tell me, I will definitely want him. I can't demand, because I'm not in a position to demand. But definitely we can, you know, say that he should, if he really aspires to be the prime minister of this country, you know, he has to be very inclusive. And the starting point is that he should at least apologize, because it is his moral responsibility towards the people that he should resign and say sorry, because Gujarat is a blot on his head, on his forehead, and it won't go away by any SIT report or any Supreme Court report. He has to say something about it.
He also held a rally in Jammu, one of his first, and he spoke about a discussion on Article 370. At that point, you said Article 370 is not like Babri Masjid that can be demolished. Mm-hmm. Now, my question is, the same party comes into government, mm-hmm. and his stand on Article 370 will remain the same, mm-hmm. even though that was seen as a diluted stand of the BJP. Mm-hmm. Then what does the PDP do? Then where does the stand go as far as the PDP?
The stand is very clear. I mean, both, you know, these called so-called secular and these communal parties are using Article 370 as a election plank. They know they can do nothing about it. Article 370 is a bridge that connects J&K with the rest of the country. So if anybody talks about, you know, abrogation of Article 370, that means he wants, you know, the relationship between J&K and rest of the country to be renegotiated. That means we have to start, we have to go back to pre-47 and then ask people of Jammu and Kashmir whether they want to be with India or not. So I don't think anybody worth his salt will be able to do anything about it. But I know both BJP are talking about this abrogation and Congress say will not allow it, but none of them can touch it.
You made a certain charge against Farooq Abdullah, saying that he made a certain statement and that has in fact resulted in the murder of one of your sarpanches in South Kashmir. Are you getting a little carried away by the poll rhetoric?
No, not at all. See, as I said earlier, all these days, National Conference has not been talking anything about as far as their performance is concerned. All the time they are talking about PDP, nexus with Hizbul Mujahideen, nexus with BJP. And some days back, Farooq Saab made a statement that it is PDP, who along with Hizbul Mujahideen have been killing National Conference workers. And you know what happens next day? Two houses of National Conference workers are attacked. And Then I think even burned down. I don't know. I'm not sure about it. But two houses. So after some time, Farooq Saab says, you know, if he had guns and bullets and whatever, he would attack PDP and teach them a lesson. Then same night, our sarpanch gets killed. So what is it that, you know, what do you think it is happening? There is a method in their madness. They want to create violence by hook or crook. They can go even after their workers, you know. They can damage them. They can do anything even to their workers and put the blame on PDP just to create that scare, just to create that fear psychosis in the state.
That's a very serious charge to make. And at the same time, there has been a certain statement made by Saeed Ali Shah Gilani that there were certain emissaries that were sent by Narendra Modi. Now, the BJP, of course, has denied it and saying that it's a mischievous thing that Saeed Ali Shah Gilani is saying. As one of the mainstream parties in the valley, how do you interpret this?
I don't know. It must be between BJP, you know, and Gilani Saab. He must be knowing the truth. How am I supposed to know whether emissaries were sent to him or not? I can't comment on that.
Finally, do you see a Modi wave?
Well, I don't think, you know, basically Modi has been made an issue into. It is more because of the UPA failures. It is more because of the rhetoric that has been going around by the National Conference leaders, by the Congress leaders, that we need to stop Modi, we need to stop Modi, Modi is going to eat up all the Muslims, and that they have themselves created a way for him. Unfortunate, which is very unfortunate, because I feel at this point of time, the failures of UPA have been such humongous, so huge, that people are today really going towards Modi.
You at this point say that people are angry about what the UPA is doing. But come state assembly elections, will PDP shy away from having an alliance with the Congress party, depending on how the results are in the valley?
Well, see, I think there is a lot of anti-incumbency factor against both the parties. We have seen it. We have seen it in Jammu. We have seen it here. So we are hoping that we will be able to, you know, pull through on our own, inshallah, hopefully. So we don't want to comment anything on, you know, any kind of alliance, because at this point of time we are fighting the parliament elections, and the alliance is between National Conference and Congress. I think it's very unethical on my part to say something about, you know, about a matter where already two people are in a partnership.
Mehbooba Mufti, is this your toughest fight as far as electoral battles go?
Well, I think every fight is a tough fight, and you know. I think I will not comment too much on it, whether it is very tough or it is toughest, but you know, for me, I take every fight very seriously.
For the National Conference's Farooq Abdullah, it is a fight against anti-incumbency that his son's government faces. Add to that, the fear of the anger against NC ally, the Congress. But standing by both his son Omar Abdullah and ally the Congress party, Farooq Abdullah seems confident. This as he launched into a scathing tirade against Narendra Modi. What is also interesting is how he came to the defense of Omar Abdullah while answering questions on the NC's tenure with the BJP in the past. Farooq Abdullah in a candid conversation with Headlines Today's Maru Kinayat.
Dr. Farooq Abdullah, you've been in Delhi all this while for the past 5 years. You've now come back, and there's an anti-incumbency factor against the Omar Abdullah government. Why are you sounding so optimistic about a win?
I don't see where this anti-incumbency factor. I don't think you've had so much done in this state that he has been able to do in 5 years. So where is anti-incumbency?
You don't see the anti-incumbency?
No, I don't see. But how did the works get on? Look at the amount of work he has done. Have people forgotten that?
Okay, maybe there might not be as much anger against Omar Abdullah, even if one were to believe that for a minute. You're an ally of the Congress party, and across the country, there seems to be a sense, a perception on the ground, is widespread anger against your ally.
How does it matter? There can be anger against the ally, but that doesn't mean that that anger should reflect on us. Why? This is a state which does its own work, and we as members of parliament put up our thing before the parliament, and as a minister I have done quite a lot for this state in the renewable energy sector that you will soon see from Ladakh, nearly 7,000 megawatts of solar power coming.
Okay.
So a lot of work has been done, and then all these backward areas, the amount of solar lights that have been given to the people who never saw lights before. So work has been done. Then number of small hydro projects that have been done by my ministry is not small.
If that were the argument, then isn't there a contradiction in what your party is saying? Because the party slogan in these elections, in this campaign, has been that a vote for PDP is a vote for Narendra Modi. Because the National Conference seems to believe that there's a tacit arrangement between the PDP and the BJP. So similarly, a vote for the National Conference will be a vote for the Congress Party, or a vote against the Congress Party will be a vote against National Conference as well?
Our plan is... a vote for Modi is for a communal party, and a vote for the National Conference and Congress combined is for secularism, for India's, what India depends on, and that is unity in diversity. It is this diversity which keeps India alive. Modi has the plans of completely distorting this diversity. It wants to put one religion in front of everybody else, and that is dangerous for this nation. We believe that India will not remain India if the policies of RSS are put up by Modi.
But you were a part of the NDA once.
That's different. When we were part of the NDA, you saw 370 they couldn't touch. There was no way they could bring in the unified civil code.
But 2002 happened, and Umar Abdullah, by his own admission, did not resign after the riot.
No, he did offer resignation to Bajpai. I was the one who held him back. The resignation was given to Bajpai. He didn't accept it. But Umar didn't want to work.
Do you think that
not
was
even
a mistake?
One day.
Do you think that was a mistake in retrospect?
Well, in the process, whatever it is now, it's over. 2002 is gone. We're thinking of future of India.
Okay, 2014.
And the future of India is dangerous.
2014, what if Narendra Modi comes to power at the center? The
well,
Jammu and Kashmir government will have to work with him.
I feel sad for India.
But you'll have to work
no,
with him.
No, I won't work with him. Why?
At the state
I will
level?
Oppose him as much as the other secular forces will oppose him once I'm in the parliament. We will oppose him. Tooth and nail will oppose him. His policies will oppose.
Do you think that perhaps he'll want to do something good for Kashmir? Why would you oppose him then? Just because of ideological differences?
If there was any possibility, that possibility does not exist. How is it possible that they want to settle up with... would they not have settled when Bajpai was the Prime Minister? Who stopped him then? It was the RSS that stopped him for further movements with Pakistan when Musharraf came to Agra and things were nearly settled. What was it that took Musharraf at 12 o'clock back in to Pakistan? Why?
But maybe
because
they,
the pressure
maybe they come back
of
with
RSS
a different...
was there.
No, but maybe they come back. This is almost presuming what's going to happen. Maybe they come
I
back with new ideas.
I presume what is absolutely true.
But are you
I
looking at...
I don't see any better relationship coming up with Pakistan. And if anybody thinks that they are going to be able to build a relationship with Pakistan... I don't see it.
Okay,
because the first and the foremost point that is Kashmir.
Okay,
is India ready to take up Kashmir with Pakistan?
Okay, let me ask you another question. In one of your recent interviews, you said that if Rahul Gandhi were to form the government at the center, Umar Abdullah will be one of the ministers.
No, and please.
You did say.
This is absolutely misusing words.
What did you mean then?
Like you, the correspondent asked me. And said, what happens? As you people put pricks, you know, and say, would you kindly say this thing? And in one way or the other, you come to the same point. And this is what exactly they said. They said, will you be the minister in his government? I said, no, I won't be the minister in the government. If Rahul Gandhi comes to the government. Will anybody else say, yes, there can be. We have so many people, they can be part of it. Then they said, would Umar do with it? I said, why not? Umar can be part of it. But it is up to Umar to decide.
Okay.
It's not for Farooq Abdullah to decide.
Okay.
And Umar has decided that he's not going to go. He's going to serve people of Kashmir. So how does it come that Farooq Abdullah is saying Umar will go there?
Okay. Finally, Dr. Abdullah, Sayyid Ali Shah Gilani has made a claim that Narendra Modi sent certain emissaries to him to say that you can directly get in touch with me. Now, the BJP has obviously said this is a mischievous thing being done by Saeed Ali Jagilani. Yeah. Now, Umar Abdullah has said that Mr. Gilani should name these emissaries. Now, my question to you is, do you believe the claim being made by Saeed Ali Shah Gilani, or do you believe the counterclaim being made by the BJP?
I do not know. So one or the other. I do not know. I do not know the emissaries. I do not know what Saeed Ali Shah Gilani wants to put in. But one thing is absolutely right. Saeed Ali Shah Gilani has, for the first time, openly said Modi will be RSS. So he has at least put the ball where it should be, made quite clear to the people of the state that Mufti, who stands with Modi, is for RSS.
Dr. Abdullah, let me be a little mischievous.
Be mischievous?
Do you want to come back to Kashmir? Do you want to be here rather than be at the center?
I've had enough.
You've had enough?
I've had enough. I have done my duty as far as the chief ministership of the state is concerned. I think time has come when the younger person is doing a good job, and inshallah he will continue to do it for many more years.
Dr. Farooq Abdullah, for speaking to Headlines today. Thank you so much.